I'm used to that. So the ones who stuck with it was like, hey, we done put in all this work and all this effort and all this time, you know, you might as well do something good because from 3-8, I mean, it took a lot of that out of me. I thought I wasn't going to make it, tell you the truth.
Go get them, boys.
Finds it to 25, breaks a couple of tackles. And look at him go! He can't go all the way! Touchdown! Touchdown! Touchdown!
Y'all ready for this?
All right, guys, we all want to know, what exactly goes on in the Muskie locker room? What?
It's like early in the week, it's relaxed, and the conversation's relaxed, and we talk about basically everything. Then Friday afternoons, people start to settle down and get ready for the game, get their game face on, and do whatever it takes to prepare themselves for the game. Then Saturday is kind of like the air is so thick in the locker, you can basically cut it with a knife.
Well, before practice, we have fun. Because we're all friends, so there's a lot of joking around and everything. But before a game, there's a lot of tension in the air, and it's quiet, and everybody has their own thing. They listen to their headphones, and some people go in the gym and throw. And people, they just kind of do their own things however they get ready for a game.
The locker room. If you could tape what happened in the locker room. The locker room is sort of like a
circus.
Yeah, it's a closed party, you know. Everyone knows that, you know, we're either going out for practice or a game. Game days and the day before games, you know, it's pretty serious in the locker room, but, you know, practice, it's just a time to let loose. It's a lot of fun. That's probably one of the things I'll miss the most about football is the times I had in the locker room.
Oh, it's fun during the week. We just go around, have a good time with the jukebox, and the jukebox are just some old, dumb, the 8-track and this and there. And the music's been, we've kind of added a couple here and there through over the past years, but it's more of we just sit around, people sing, Hogan will dance. People just joke around, and then it kind of, Friday, some people don't joke around as much, but like Fridays will calm down a little bit, and then they don't play music as much on Fridays. Sometimes they do. And then Saturdays is just, everyone kind of does their own thing. Some people all attend, some people still screw around.
Tell me what goes on in the locker room, Kirkland.
I mean, I can't do that. First of all, I don't think you can allow that.
Well, we'll have to censor that one quite a bit. If you've seen any movies like Major League or something like that, it's pretty much the truth. No, that's pretty much when everyone gets together, and that's really when we start becoming a team, is inside the locker room. That's how everyone truly, you can tell how people truly are.
During the week, it's different than what it is on a Friday before a game and day of a game. During the week, people are laid back and the jukebox is playing and people are having fun. And then come Thursday night and Friday, people start to get more serious. There's a whole different atmosphere.
About our jukebox, we got some great songs on there. We got New Kids on the Block's latest one. A lot of good stuff on there. It brings a team together.
Brad's not afraid to get up and show everyone how to dance.
No, I can, you know, do the way.
He always has the latest move.
Yeah.
Myself? I don't even want to answer that. I'm sorry.
Well, you know, just like people say, the old locker room talk, you know, there's a lot of things said in the locker room that probably shouldn't be said, and a lot of things in the locker room that are made up just to tease each other, but we have a good time in the locker room. In fact, we have a little joke going that, you know, football would be great. We could do it all year and not have to worry about going out and practice anything. We just come in the locker room every day and fool around with each other. it would be great instead of having to go out and run all the time. So we have a good time in the locker room.
We clown around, talk, sort of like a male bonding thing. Nothing really. We don't talk about girls like y'all probably think. Not bad.
They wouldn't let me take my video camera in the locker room, so I guess it remains a mystery.
Has been tremendous. We have 11 seniors in our program right now, and those guys have gone through a lot during the 4 years they've been here. We've had some disappointing seasons, but at the same time they've stayed very positive and shown us good leadership. I think the other thing that's really important for us is the experience that we've had over the last 3 or 4 years with these players, and they've gotten a lot of experience even though they didn't win a lot of games their first 2 or 3 years here at Muskingum. They've gained valuable experience, and even last year when we looked at our season, we lost 4 games by less than a touchdown. So we felt like with an experienced team and good leadership, we could turn those close games into wins and then have a successful winning season.
Seniors and their parents, number 32, John Busby and Sandy Jackson. Number 53, David Hendricks, escorted by Gary and Darlene Hendricks. Number 30, Brent Hogan, escorted by Janice Hogan. Number 16, Bubba Kidwell, escorted by Kim and Rita Kidwell. Number 79, Rick Kitzmiller, escorted by Tim and Carol Kitzmiller. Number 25, Chad Paul, escorted by Marty and Marilyn Paul. Number 13, Ben Snively, escorted by John and Marilyn Snively. Number 22, Connor Thompson, escorted by Tom and Linda Thompson. Number 18, Sean Trickey, escorted by Kathleen Trickey. Number 52, Tyson Veit, escorted by Chris and Karen Veit. And number 83, Shane Ward, escorted by Walt and Jody Ward and Brother Brandy.
Mountains are the self-moving. Take what's more than I'm not good in front of cameras. We don't relate. All right, what do you want to talk about? All right, tell me. All right. First of all, you must need 11 players on the field. And they basically hit each other's guts out and for no reason. So, I like it. And I don't know what to say in front of the camera.
I think you should stick with football.
Because I need to stick with football.
That's why Pat did his hair, Ben.
How much is all of this on your arm?
Proud being out there and seeing the team and walking out there and just going through the motions. And it's just, man, I don't know.
Take two.
Don't take a minute now.
What?
What do you feel when you walk on the field?
I'd like to get dressed.
Wes Betts is one of the most talented athletes I know.
He's overrated. Take two, ready?
Seriously, I was being nice.
Yeah.
You've been.
No. So I was trying to.
Never mind.
Take two. Ready? Stop it.
Wes Betts is still the most talented athlete I've ever. Get him in the game, coach.
And that's how a bill becomes a law. I think it keeps me from having bad luck.
No, I will not make out with you.
Go, Muskie!
I think Muskie football is guys and tight pants.